Hi everyone, welcome to Joe's Learning Hub, a one-stop channel for teacher trainees. In today's lecture, you'll be listening to Dr. Radhakrishnan Commission. At the end of the session, you'll be able to know why Dr. Radhakrishnan Commission was set up, list the aims of Radhakrishnan Commission, state the recommendations given by Radhakrishnan Commission, and describe the structure of education recommended by Radhakrishnan Commission. First, you should know that Dr. Radhakrishnan Commission was the first education commission after independence. This was in the year 1948-49. This commission is also called as University Education Commission because this commission was set up for the improvement and reorganization of university education. Hence, this commission is otherwise called University Education Commission. This commission was named after Dr. Radhakrishnan, the second president of our country, and also he was the vice chancellor of Banaras Hindu University at that time. He was the chairman of University Education Commission, and this commission comprised of 10 members, among whom 6 were Indian members and 4 were foreign members. All the members were educational experts from renowned universities. This commission was set up in the year 1948 in the month of November for the improvement and reorganization of university education. The members prepared questionnaires and sent to 600 educationists for information of university education in all aspects. Based on the feedback from the 600 educationists, they prepared a report. And the report consisted of 2 volumes, wherein first volume was the report as such, and the second volume was the data of the study. So this is the general introduction on Dr. Radhakrishnan Commission. Now let's move on to the aims of Radhakrishnan Commission. The major aims of Radhakrishnan Commission was to bring changes in aims of education based on socio-political scenario. The second is they wanted to bring the leadership training among students at the university level. They also wanted to bring social efficiency at the higher level. Development of knowledge and wisdom among the students at university level, and higher values of life was insisted, and also to develop the cultural progress among students at university level. So these are the aims of Dr. Radhakrishnan Commission. Now let's move on to the general recommendations given by Dr. Radhakrishnan Commission. First is to train for democracy. Everything is for the students of university level, that is higher education students, to train for democracy, to train self-development, to develop values, to develop spirit of tolerance and secularism, to acquaint with cultural heritage, to develop understanding of present as well as the past, and to give vocational and professional training. So these are all the general recommendations given by Dr. Radhakrishnan Commission for the improvement of university education. Now let's see what was the structure of education given by Radhakrishnan Commission. They recommended admission to university only after 12 years of schooling. And then they recommended that UG or the undergraduation must be of 3 years, and the students must be admitted to PG or the post-graduation only if they completed 1 year of study beyond UG degree. So this is the structure of undergraduation and post-graduation. I'll repeat, post-graduation must be given to those students who complete 1 more year of study after their UG degree. And the total number of working days was recommended to be 180 days, and they should have 3 terms of 11 weeks duration. This 180 working days excludes examination days. And they recommended that the students in university must be of 3000 in number, and students in affiliated colleges must be 500. They also recommended continuous evaluation, and they wanted the internal assessment to be introduced in the evaluation. They suggested the inclusion of objective type questions and also oral examination. And they suggested the curriculum must have Indian history and Indian philosophy, as the students must know the present as well as the past. For the professional education, they recommended starting up of universities in agriculture, commerce, education, engineering and technology, law, medicine, business administration, public administration, and industrial relations. So they recommended separate universities for these courses and they termed it as professional education. And they also recommended the starting up of a UGC, that is University Grants Commission, in order to look after into the issues at the university level. They insisted that the language should be in English at higher levels for learning, teaching and writing. And then they suggested that the textbooks can be in mother tongue. And for teacher education, they felt the importance of practice teaching, and the student teachers must be evaluated based on the practice teaching. They also suggested suitable schools to be selected for teaching. This was a recommendation given by Dr. Radhakrishnan Commission for Teacher Training. That is, practice of teaching, evaluation based on teaching. Next recommendation is starting up of rural universities with rural colleges having importance to agriculture and industry. They also felt the need of having hospitals and health service in the universities. They suggested regular medical checkup for students. They also insisted on having NCC and physical training for the students at a college level. They felt the need for sanitary inspection in all colleges and universities. And they recommended same facilities for women's universities like that of men. So these are all the recommendations suggested by Dr. Radhakrishnan Commission for the university education. So my dear students, by now you must have understood why Radhakrishnan Commission was set up, the aims of Radhakrishnan Commission, the general recommendations and the structure of education suggested by Radhakrishnan Commission. Do not forget, Dr. Radhakrishnan Commission is otherwise called as University Education Commission, and it was started for the improvement of university education, and Mudaliar Commission was started for the improvement of higher secondary education. Until we meet again, thank you.